The Monee Phillips Show.
You got it, you got it, girl.
You got it.
You got it, you got it, girl.
You got it.
You got it, you got it, girl.
You got it.
You the best. You the best.
Yes, it's your boy DJ KMO, represent the Monee Phillips Show. Here are your host, Monee Phillips.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Monee Phillips Show, and I am your host, Monee Phillips. Welcome, everybody. Y'all, we are here on the Monee Phillips Show, man. Of course, man, I am so happy to have these fantastic guests, of course, and we having a bad storm, but guess what? We gonna rock the house tonight on the Monee Phillips Show! Man, I wouldn't have it no other way, man. I always talk about promoting yourself in your business, and this is the place to do it, so I know y'all looking and saying, what's this behind me? But I got to let you know, man, y'all do not want to miss this show, so I'm gonna have a seat and call my first guest. All right. Well, welcome, y'all. Let me slide on up here. Well, y'all, look, I got a special guest in the house, man. I met him at a networking event, fashion show event with Tawana, and I'm telling you right now, this man right here has something that y'all gotta see, so no other to do. Come on to the Monee Phillips Show and grab that microphone and have a seat. How you doing?
Great, great.
All right, so introduce yourself.
My name is Jacarlos Crockham.
All right.
Some people call me Carlos, but have you? Please to call me, that's fine.
So tell me a little bit about yourself.
I'm a country boy from the SIP, as we call it,
okay.
From Cleveland, Mississippi. So, moved to Memphis in 98 and been here ever since. So,
okay.
Memphis is Memphis.
Yes.
So, come from a small town, you know, which is, a lot of things that happen there is bigger here.
Yeah.
So, I had to adapt.
Okay.
So, I'm glad to be in Memphis.
Okay. So being in Memphis, you became an entrepreneur, got your own clothing brand, of course.
Right,
so tell
her
about this clothing brand and how you started with this.
Started in 2019.
Mm-hmm.
God gave me a vision. Give all praise to God. Gave me a vision to start Croc Breeds.
Okay.
And I started to put it down at first, but he told me to pick it back up.
Yeah.
I didn't think people would believe in it.
Okay.
I had that fear. So I had to pray and ask God to give me the courage and boldness to put it back out there. So I picked it back up, and everybody like, man, that's dope.
Mm-hmm.
Man, bring it back out. You know, what's next?
Yes.
So I said to myself, I said, I want to take it to another level.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, God, I need people around me and resources to push it out there. So he's been going 360 with it.
Okay.
And I started because the tree represents the tree of life.
Okay.
And as you would, you know, seeing on the shirts or whatnot, the red line is representation of the blood of Jesus Christ.
Okay.
And producing good fruits, which is whatever your good fruits would be to fulfill your purpose, which may be achievement, knowledge, wisdom, anything will help you to push yourself out there to fulfill your purpose. So the blood coming from the roots to, you know, the trees.
So, okay, okay. Yeah, so that was the vision or the design. So what made you come up with the name?
Croc Breeds. My last name is Crockham.
Okay.
Building legacy. Legacy is something we all should push.
Yes.
Because especially if you have family, you have kids, you want to leave something to.
That's right.
I have a son, actually, and I want to leave this to him.
Okay.
And whatever he want to push out, that God give him the purpose to do as well.
Yes.
So building legacy. So my last name is Crockham. So I cut off the AM and left Croc.
Okay.
Breeze, which
okay.
is a different, you know, twist.
Yeah, different
of fashion.
Twist. Yes, it
so,
is.
Yeah,
it
so
is.
I want to keep it like
it
this.
Is. Now, how did you come up with the creativity of the shoe? Because you know, designing your shoe is like, oh, you know, we got to make it different, and you wanted a certain look. So what made you come up with how you want to design the shoe? Because it can go for any of the shoes in the store, you know.
I wanted to keep it simple.
Uh-huh.
I like All Star. I like the brand. I like the feel of it. One of my friends said, you know, when you push the shoe out, make sure people feel the shoe.
Okay.
So I wanted to make sure it was accustomed to what people know.
Okay.
And people know the throwback,
mm-hmm.
which is All-Star.
Yeah.
Converse.
Yes.
So it's sporty but classy shoe. You can wear it anywhere. I tried it myself. Wore it in the snow, rain, mud.
Okay.
Worked out
in it. Well, you walked in the rain in it tonight.
So yeah, I wanted to, you know, make sure it's doable for everybody.
Okay.
And I also have the Bible verse in the tongue of the shoe. You can wear it down. Okay. You can be hip with it.
That's dope.
You can wear it up, you know what I'm saying, kind of dress.
Yeah.
Classy with it. So the Bible verse is Philippians 4:13. Can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. That is a verse that stuck with me even through childhood.
Yes, all of us.
A lot of us can, you know, relate to that. So what I thought when I put that verse in the shoe, we all can walk. When you buy a pair of the shoes, mm-hmm. you can walk in purpose.
Uh-huh, yes.
And that verse will stick with you wherever you go, as long as you have it in your heart first.
Yeah.
And actually when you have the shoe on.
Okay. I can dig that. Y'all, I'm telling you, this is dope, man. I like how he's dressing it. He got them on right now on his feet right now. And I love how he came up being creative about that. And that's his own style and unique style. And I always tell people, do your own unique style and your own brand. That way you can be the originator. You know, anybody else cop out for you, you be like, you know, you cop out for me. But it's all good. It's all good, though. That means you inspire somebody, you know what I'm saying, to go for it. And then they might change it up and switch it up, you know, do things. I always tell people, you know, you always see somebody do something, but sometimes y'all have to realize coming up with your own idea is very different and unique instead of doing what someone else does because they line up may be totally different.
Totally different.
You turn around and be like, but how they do that? You know, how you going to do that? That's how you have to do that. So, you know, you have different types of shirts here. Do you cater to just the men or in the women or the children? Or how do you cater to?
I do both.
Okay.
The kids, the women, and the men.
So, okay.
The pink, the white, and the purple for the spring time that's coming up.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? In the summer as well.
Okay.
So I have crop tops coming out, tanks for women as well. So the other three, the red, the gray, and the black, those are the original.
Okay.
Brand when I first started.
So
I take those very seriously. I try to get a lot of people like those because they have the shoe on the back and the logo on the front.
Okay. Okay.
So it kind of, you know, kind of have a twist to it.
Mm-hmm.
Rather than the one over there by you, they just have the tree on the front, which is cool too. I like both. All of them dope.
Okay.
So how
has business been since you have done this, getting, you know, stepping out of faith, doing, you know, this type of work? Is like, woo, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
it's iffy.
It's a journey. Mm-hmm. It was a journey.
Yeah.
I give credit to my folks.
Yeah.
My mom, my dad, my granddad. He's no longer with them, but he instilled the work ethic that I have.
Yeah.
My grandma.
Yeah.
You know, I can go on and on.
Yeah.
You know? So my family, they always supported me, which is a great thing, because most people who, especially blacks, you know, I want to put it out there, we don't have that backing.
Yeah.
You know, we don't have that support group that we need.
Mm-hmm.
And then we kind of put our purpose down.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to tell everybody, don't put your purpose down. Let it continue to grow.
That's right.
Whether who's with you or not.
Yeah.
Because God gave that to you and only you.
Yeah.
You know, so I want to make that clear. So, but I came up with that. With crop breeds, and my people liked it.
Yeah.
And I want to make sure that before I put it out there, that it would cater to everyone.
Everyone, yes.
Not just the male, not just the woman, not just the kid, everyone. So God put it on my mind to make sure it goes worldwide.
Yeah.
So it's representing not only just locally, but I want to push it worldwide as well.
Okay.
And business is going pretty good.
Okay.
You know, God is blessing.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
I would say he's taking me for a journey.
Well, you know, I have noticed about you, I be telling them all the time, promoting, taking pictures with your brand on is very important.
Yeah.
How you gonna sell it if no one sees you with it on? You know what I'm saying? So I have seen different styles of unique ways you have took pictures in your work, and I was just looking like, okay, wow, you know, that will make you wanna buy it, you know what I'm saying? Because it's a different look or whatever. And I tell people all the time, so you end up taking pictures with women with the clothes on and all that kind of stuff.
True.
So when they start seeing stuff like that, then they know what your bargain is, what you're buying, and what it's going to look like on them.
They can feel it.
Yeah. So, man, I mean, I can tell you right now, I can see a lot of brothers wearing this shoe. You know what I'm saying? Styling it up, you know, because everybody go through, you know, they wear they you know, they wear suits now, but they wear shoes, dress up shoes, you know what I'm saying? So I can see a lot of people wearing those and the shirts, you know, is authentic, you know, just really how he just told you how he came up with the design. It's like, wow, you know what I'm saying? That's why I like about people doing their own little thing, their own twist of selling their merchandise. You know, it's very, you know, it looks like it's easy when you come up with a design. You're like, I got my own brand.
It's a journey.
But then you got to put investment in the money.
Yeah, it is.
Then you got to make sure you got the right quality of brand of clothing that you use. Not just getting a shirt, because, you know, a lot of people can get these cheap shirts. And the design do not come out right. You know what I'm saying? The design be all off. Yeah. You know, wiggling. I'm like, what is wrong with this shirt?
You got to get the right
quality shirts.
True.
You know, I be telling them, you have to shop around. You have to look. You have to see what you can get so you can have the right quality. You want your design to stand out. And, you know, with soft cotton shirts, pretty much, they really give you that look that you're looking for your designs to come out. It's a lot of tasks, y'all. I'm telling y'all right now.
If you want
your stuff to look right, then you want people to buy it. And you're investing in yourself. It takes time, y'all. You can't just go and buy a whole box of this stuff and one wop. Sometimes it don't be like that. You might not even want that style like that. You might well come up with another creative style also. So, you know, button down shirts. You might decide to do a button down shirt with the sign on the side of, you know what I'm saying?
It's coming.
Yep, see what I'm saying? So, you know, just thinking of ideas, the bottle cap hats. You know, it's a lot of creative things that you can do with the towels and everything. Man, I'm telling you, I've seen it. I have done it. I can tell you. But, you know, it just takes time to invest. And just taking time. Do not quit doing whatever you love to do.
Right.
If you got a brand out here, go on, push it. You never know. It's gonna bite. But you gotta invest in it, and you gotta do all the hard work. The hard work is promoting yourself. You can't just stop in one place. I always tell everybody, when you're promoting, you gotta go to these events. You gotta do a podcast. You gotta do all those kind of things so people know who you are. Because a lot of time, people get slept on their business. They're not promoting. And that's why I tell people all the time, like, look, I bring you on the show because a lot of people don't know who you are. We have so many business owners in Memphis. You can't even tell who's who. You be like, oh, you got a business, where is it? Because they don't promote it.
Yeah.
You only see, if you see it on social media, that's a rare. Because all the time, people don't be on social media sharing, and you may not be friends with so-and-so and so-and-so. Then you got the haters. They don't want to share your stuff.
Right. Just because.
So they won't share your stuff. But then when they looking for something, they say, girl, I got a girlfriend. She got a boutique. Then the men cologne, you know, the men stuff and the men clothing line. So guess what? I just thought of something. Now, y'all, I've been telling y'all that I am the wardrobe stylist for Rip Entertainment Films.
Okay.
I just said yesterday, I said, men are the hardest to persuade to put their clothing in anything. I can talk, I can be the cutest little thing. Hey, how you doing? They looking like, well, what I'm going to get out of? You know, people, men don't think like the women would.
Right,
the women would hurry up and be like, of course. You know what I'm saying? But guess what? I'm going to put his clothing brand in the movie, in Krim's movie.
Let's go.
And we're going to get them some shirts in that movie. So he's going to be one of my men designers that we're going to have. They're going to be wearing his brand. His movie going to be all over the world.
Cool.
Tubi, TV. So, man, y'all get ready. I told y'all first. You'll get a chance to meet Krim. So, you know, get a chance to see other the artists that he have in the movie. So I had told my actors yesterday, I told Krim that, I said, y'all give me a minute. I got to look at and brand these men. Stylists, women, I got tons of them. Please leave me boutiques everywhere. Everybody rich. But I don't have that many women in that movie. But the next movie coming, man, we finna go all in. So I'm gonna be getting in touch with a lot of designers and me and the designers right now. I'm trying to get because we
that's
finna
awesome.
Do something heavy. And
that's
I want
awesome.
And I'm gonna reach out to you so you can get a chance to meet the crew and the staff.
Yeah.
And man, we're gonna do some things. So see, you never know. coming on the show can benefit you in all ways.
That's awesome.
Okay?
That's awesome.
And you never know. So I told you, don't be sleeping on me. So yesterday, we had our premiere yesterday, and we had Krim movie came out. We had did a premiere called Play. And who pops up? MJG. And DJ Legendary Squeaky came in. Okay. So you just don't never know who's gonna be around to come see the movie. And you know, and I'm just excited about what's coming ahead. And actually having me as one of the stylists is gonna be something dope for Memphis, so y'all can get y'all clothing brand out here in this film.
Yeah.
And so I thought that That's would dope. Be wonderful to do.
That'd
so, man,
awesome.
Make sure y'all get tuned in, because, man, I'm telling y'all, it's going to be a dope summer, and we're going to be filming our butt off. So y'all get with me. So, look, tell the people how they can order or how they can attain the shoes or anything.
You can follow me at CrocBreeze_footwear_apparel. On IG and on Facebook, Carlos Crockham.
Okay.
Follow me, Carlos Crockham. My phone number is 901-262-2516. If you want to contact me there. Also, just shoot me an email, the letter jcrockham@gmail.com.
Okay, so on the shoes level, are they expensive like you be in the store?
Well, actually, they're not too expensive.
Okay.
They're $189.
Okay, that ain't bad.
But I have like discounts I offer to people who want to just say, man, what you got?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Can I get a little something?
But
you know,
ain't
so
bad.
Yeah, it's not
bad. It's
so
different. It's custom
and
made.
And it's quality. It comes from Italy.
Okay.
So it's custom made.
Yeah, it's custom made. You'll pay that for custom made. So, you know, half y'all got the fake stuff on anyway. Stop playing with me. Y'all ain't paying no D-ball for no shoes. Y'all stop playing for it. But anyway, you know, fake it to make it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
we know what we do. Real life here, man.
Yeah, so, but yeah, it's a good quality shoe, though.
Okay.
Good quality clothes, shoes, a lot of other things coming up. So stay tuned.
Okay.
And, yeah, so actually, I have something for you.
All right.
Yeah, so this is.
And yours. He got my favorite color, y'all, red. That's what I'm talking about. So I will be sporting this, so they'll get a chance to see. I love gifts, y'all, so you make sure y'all support my guy, man. I'm always wearing everybody's stuff, man. Everybody that give me something, I'm always wearing. I really thank you so much. This is more to come, y'all. You just never know what's going to happen for you being on the show. A lot of things I have connections with. And this is one of the connections, and meeting him, for the first time at a Warner event, man. And, you know, just networking. You just never know who in the building.
Definitely.
You never know who you're around and seeing people, you know what I'm saying? So when I seen him and I told him, just call me and we get him on the show so we can brand his items and stuff. And I'm just excited to see you progressing. Progressing. That's amazing things going on. So never know what's gonna happen. So I was just like I said, Jeff was talking about finding men stylists to style the men, and here you go. So we got another stylist. So we're gonna keep on continue looking. If you have a clothing brand, this is a perfect opportunity for you to brand yourself on TV, promote yourself, let everybody know what you got going on, what they seeing. So you can be out there so people can get your brands, you know. Don't sleep on it now. This is very important. Promoting is very important, and that's the reason why I do the show. So make sure y'all do that. So, look, thank you for coming on the Monee Phillips Show.
Thank
you so much. Now, look, don't y'all go nowhere.
I'm gonna say one more thing.
Go ahead.
I'd like to give a shout-out to my family.
Okay.
Like I said before, my supporters, my team, my homeboys, T. Bradford, T. Roberts, everyone who helped me to put this together.
Yes.
I don't want to leave you out. God has put together a great purpose I want to give to the world, so don't want to leave you out.
Okay.
And I have a saying that I tell people, chin up, chest out. God made us kings and queens for a reason.
Yes.
You know, you have a purpose, embrace that, and let your purpose be greater than your fear.
That's right. That's good. That's a good one, y'all. So look, y'all, look, don't y'all go nowhere. Of course, we got a live performance in the building. A very important artist gonna come on the Monee Phillips Show. So do not go anywhere. Turn it up, DJ King Mo on the one.
We are going to a commercial break. Don't be long, don't stay gone. You in the mix with your boy DJ King Mo. Represent the Monee Phillips Show.
Hey! Pandit. Panda. Legacies. happens stays between you and me.
Got a proposition, but come work for me, nigga. You'll never be a number bomb in your life.
What's this?
That's my blood pressure medicine, man.
You think I'm stupid? You high as a kite.
Stupid bitches.
Well, words on the streets that he was in a gang, and I guess his enemies got to him first.
He claim I know everything. You know damn well I don't know everything. Keep your sick ass at home, then.
One thing that I've noticed is that you're respected in your neighborhood. Around here, people love you and they respect you.
If you ever talk back to me again, I'll kill your ass.
But it's my block, you know?
You saw what? Deep in the business. You know, I feel like...
I used to get high. You're talking about so high, I didn't know whether I was talking about going.
Bitch ass nigga, who am I supposed
to be? You was out in the world. You was out.
Hey, y'all, come on, let's go, come on.
Shit, you on crack. This shit ain't
gonna
end well, I can tell you that.
She's lying.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
We are back on the Monee Phillips Show. Just like I told you, we got a fantastic artist in the building on the Monee Phillips Show. Come on down on the Monee Phillips Show. Take that microphone and have a seat.
I got you.
All right. Well, welcome.
Good evening.
So tell everybody who you are.
I go by Mikey Christian. I'm a hip-hop artist, actor, writer.
Doing your thing, man. I'm telling y'all, he's been performing and doing a lot of things in Memphis. So tell everybody how long you've been in the game.
Man, the crazy part, the first time I ever like rapped in front of people, I was like 10.
Okay.
Yeah, I was at a Halloween party, and my cousin was DJing. He just gave me the microphone, mm-hmm. and I just went in.
Okay. And so just the passion in it. That's what you love to do.
Yeah.
So you do more of the rapper. You do any R&B singing or anything you try to sing?
I might try to vibe depending on how I feel. If I'm in my feelings, I might go that route.
A lot of them do. They always start it off, rapping and say, well, I'm going to try the little thing and see if it'll work. But then I ain't no plan, so I'm going to go back. Let me go back. But, I've been seeing you doing your thing, man. Of course, you got your own unique style and dance when you're performing. So your live performance, and I seen you at the, you was down there at the Shell. Was it Shell?
Yeah.
So how was that? Because I know they do bands.
Man.
How you actually perform with the band? Were you pretty good doing that?
Yeah, I prefer bands because I feel like they can turn up a record.
Yes.
I feel like a record can only be so hard unless, you got the band to really dissect the sounds put it together. So,
I tell people all the time, be unique when you're dealing with that. Man, a lot of people be like, man, no DJ here. they can't rap. I be like, y'all can't perform, but y'all got to have a DJ because, you just never know what may happen. And having a band, helps things out. And where you can really be unique with it, your own style.
Yeah.
And nobody can copy it.
No,
tell everybody like that. You performing live with a band, that's your own unique style. Mm-hmm. So I tell people when you go to the award shows, what they have?
The bands.
They don't have no DJ.
You got to prepare yourself for those big moments, even though if you're not... there yet. You're going to get there eventually.
Yeah, so I told you that's the pros and cons of being an artist. Having artist development is very important. Learning how to perform is very important. A lot of people don't have the performance level. And then that way, you're trying to draw the attention of the crowd. So if your performance level is not correct.
it's a real art to it, though.
Yeah.
It's just like any sport that you play.
You know,
you can only get so good if you the practice going to determine wherever you go.
So. And so how you feel, like how you end up drawing your crowd more into the dancing or the rapping or what?
I feel like it's like the confidence.
Okay.
I feel like if anything you do, your confidence really going to determine your outlook on things or how people look at what you got going on. If you don't take it seriously, they not going to take it seriously.
Nah, I tell everybody that very so. You know, taking things seriously is important. You know, a lot of people get out here and like, I can rap, I can do this, but then get up there and freeze. They freeze, but I'm telling you, it's a lot of them get scared like, man, it wasn't right, man, the sound. You blame it on the sound, man, and you know the whole time was you. Now, you know.
You said the light man, everybody.
Look, I'm going to tell y'all right now. Being an artist, you have to be, you know, pretty much physical, athletic, pretty much, because it takes your breath. So a lot of time people be like, I can rap. Man, why are you going to be out of breath? You know, you dance two-step and get to sing. Man, you might as well stand in one place.
Them lights get to hitting you doing 20 minutes in front of them hot lights or 30 minutes.
Man, so I'm telling you, being a performer is more than just, you know, just standing in one place or being at the studio, being performance level, you know what I'm saying? You know, a lot of people want to do their CDs and everything, but then you got a lot of people that have not even went out there and performed.
Facts.
They'll be like, I had to drop like 15 album release and singles and stuff. Like, man, have you done before? I'm like, nah, I ain't got this for you. You know, I'm like, man, if you dropping all these and nobody know the song, it's just by a YouTube hit. You know what I'm saying?
You got to perform it somewhere to really test it to see if it's.
Well, you come on the Monee Phillips Show, we're going to determine if you the hit or what. I'm here to help you, man. I'm here to help you to make you grow so people get a chance. You know, where's the opportunity you get a chance to be on TV, do a live performance where you'll be able to have artist development? This is what this is, artist development, pretty much to help you with far as interviews and live performances. These are performances to help you. These are resumes. So anytime you see yourself on doing podcasts and TV talk shows, those are resumes for you. So when you'll be able to go to someone and say, yeah, I have done resumes. I have a few. I have done talk shows. I talk about my brand, what work I got out here, projects, performance. You can see me live on the morning. You got plenty of pictures. You know, a lot of y'all ain't got pictures. Y'all still taking pictures behind the car. In the bathroom shots. You know, I can't find a decent picture. Y'all got to crop your face out and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, I'm trying to help you. So that's why we doing it like we do. We professionally give you some professional pictures so you can have to show. They look, I got a live performance picture showing me doing my thing, backdrops and everything. So we're going to help y'all out. You know what I'm saying? This is what we're here for. We here to do this, you know, to make it happen for you. So you will be able to say, I've been on the Monee Phillips Show, and I turned it up, and I did my thing. Now it's on to the next. Now, look, now when I get you on the Monee Phillips Show, don't y'all stop. Y'all continue the process. The process is go to more interviews. You got Jazzy Jeff that does interviews. Man, do spins after spin. Put your money where your mouth is. Man, the spins go all over the world. They play your music every so often, maybe 5 or 6 times a day. He got the hours. You know, I don't remember the hours, but I know he does that for sure. And people all over the world listening to it. So those will be a great interviews for you. You know, so if you're thinking about going on Jazzy Jeff, tell Monee send you over there so you can get some, you know, get it going on. There's different places you can do, you know, chat way that way. Y'all pay your money, $10, I think it's still 10, on Monday nights, you know, where you can, everybody get a chance to hear your music and, man, you know, trash it or whatever, chat well that way, you know how it go. Everybody watching her establishment. So, man, it's so many. Now, if you want to do raw and uncut, then, you know, you got to go over there to the other people, you know, where they, you know, you want freestyle. Hey, we ain't with the freestyle here. We want to hear what projects you got out open right now so people can buy. You can freestyle anyway. This ain't it. This ain't rap battle. You know, rap battle, I mean, that'd be cool, though. You know, good. I might think about that hell idea. But, you know, I just wanted to be able to help you brand your project and make things happen for you so you can sell what you are working hard for every day, man. This is like a hard task, you know, finding the right music to grab the audience and making sure they buy it, you know what I'm saying? So a lot of times, you know, it ain't like how we was back in the day. You go to Walmart and tell, you know, Poo Poo and Ray Ray out there got this $5 CD, and you trying to give it to them, and you be like, man, just $5. You don't know what you could be worse than the devil. I don't know. But that time, too, you may not even put it in your CD because you're scared. You're like, I don't know what this sounds like. So we're going to stop all of that. We're going to bring you on the show so they'll be able to know what they're getting into, what they listening to, so they can be able to say, all right, yeah, I like that. Let me copy that. Because, you know, we get downtown. I ain't going to lie. I had thousands of them come my car. Hey, $5, bro. Just get the $5, man. I don't even know what a CD is.
Keep
I don't
CD. Want to
play that in my car. There ain't no gospel music down to play. But I support a lot of artists. But, you know, it just had in my mind to do the show. What did I wanted to do? And I was looking at so many artists that talk about their project. Man, I got my new release album coming out March 23rd, you know. And you don't even know what you buying. You just said, Luda, you be looking like, okay, yeah, man, you my dog, I'm a buy. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, man, I'm gonna follow you, I'm gonna listen to it. Now, y'all need to cut all these 50 albums and one project. Cut that stuff down. Ain't nobody listening to no 50 songs. I like Jay-Z and P. Diddy, but ain't nobody for the listen to no 50. Man, cut that stuff down, man. Call it another project. You know what I'm saying? Limit those times. Get your hottest hits, the first five hottest hit, then the rest of them you don't think so hot, let they be the judge. You know what I'm saying? But at least by 10.
No, the crazy part is.
It's about 10 on it. Man, y'all be killing me with these, man. About 50, man. Drop the biggest album could, man. About 50 albums. I be like, I'm not finna listen. No, I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm not finna listen 50. Dad, maybe 10 to 13.
That's a lot. You know? 50 is a lot.
I done heard a lot of them did it. Like 28 songs in one project. You know, like. Yeah. Man, y'all doing it.
Yeah. All you need is 5 songs. I got a project out now, see, EP, 5-hit combo.
Five.
Only 5 songs.
Five.
That's all you need. That's all you need.
5. You know what I'm saying? Make it happen. So, man, people can, you know, say, okay, you know, I see what you got going on. Let's go to something else and, you know, brand another project. But, man, I'm telling y'all, man, chop them things up. And quit making these projects long. You don't have to be next year. Before you get it out. You know what I'm saying? Man, people got it making it hard for themselves. You know what I'm saying? I'm just telling y'all. Very simple. And then most of the time, people don't even get a chance to even listen to all their music on their project. So then you just wasted, you know, time because everybody not listening to it. So cut this stuff down, y'all. Cut it down.
Please.
And brand it. And, you know, and make sure y'all have pictures, decent pictures, you know, invest in yourself, you know, get professional photos done. Make sure y'all, you know, put your money where your mouth is. You want best videos and all of that. Man, it's investment in being an artist, y'all. So just like y'all see everybody putting their money into, you always put your money in. Just like when you get signed, they give you money, upfront money. You know, they're not your money. That's upfront money. So I have to let the folks know that this is upfront money when you sign. So everybody ready to sign. But, you know, Ms. Mary was just speaking about that. My PR, she was just stating about people ready to get signed. But, you know, you have to realize it's better to be independent.
Yes.
Real serious. You're putting your own money up. You ain't got to worry about, you know, you paying that money back or whatever. That's what Gotti got going on. All them, Young Dolph, all them was independent.
True.
Independent. So, you know, just think about that. But everybody ready to get paid to get that money right away, which is not your money. But you're going to look rich, though.
Yeah, you're going to look rich.
But you're going to be worth it. You're going to work. You're going to pay them debts off. But, you know, just as part of being an artist. And I'm excited about a lot of people that have came on the Monee Phillips Show that has done so many great things, signed with a lot of people. Glorilla, you know, signed, and Gloss signed, and you got so many other people that came on the show that's with Big Boogie that came, Mike Edwards. He have been with Big Boogie and doing his thing as far as music, you know, getting his music out and stuff. So, man, you just never know who been on the Monee Phillips Show and had an interview and, man, doing great things. I would shout out to all of the artists that have came and been over some years since they've been here that has been development very well, and I really excited about that, knowing that y'all came on my show to do the interview. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to them. Shout out to you for creating the platform.
Thank you. So man, we gonna make sure y'all get in tune into it. So what is this project that you got out? What's the name of the project?
It's called Fire Hit Combo. I didn't want to do like how you said with the long projects, because I know people got kind of short, attention spans.
Yes.
So I just stuck it to 5 songs. I was like, y'all hold on to this till we bring out the full project.
Okay.
It's just something to hold people.
Yeah. That's how you supposed to do it. He already telling you, he already thought before I even said this, this is what he was going to do. So you performing tonight. What song you going to perform tonight?
Tonight I'm going to perform Vince. I wrote this song about Vince Carter. Mm-hmm. It was crazy because I had this moment in 2020 where I had like a crazy car wreck. And my fracture, like my hand, and I couldn't. Every time I looked at Vince Carter, he had his arm in the rim, and I'm like, "Well, my hand is all right. Mm-hmm. I can do that." So that was like my sign of like growth and recovery through my whole process.
Okay. Like I was telling y'all all the time, a lot of time people come up with, their songs on events that happened in their life, and that's the testimony in a lot of people's songs, telling what they experienced, and very deep. But you wouldn't know unless you pay attention or listen to it. Some of the songs you have to really listen to deep. Now, some of y'all get to doing these songs, I don't even know what you said. Poo Poo Ray Ray did something, I don't know. He did something, I don't know.
He did something, but
just be clear or minded on what you want your testimony. Every music is a testimony. Everything you do is a testimony. So I don't care if you have your own business or being an artist. Everything that you do is a testimony. People want to hear that. If you want to put it in your music so they can hear it, then let them understand and feel it. In order to say, feel the pain, feel it. You know what I'm saying? So I understand that very well. I think every time I talk about the show and how I started and other things, man, people get a chance to feel the pain of what your growth ethic is. And where you came from then and where you coming from now. So, man, just be mindful. You want people to be able to, brand you and support you, write it and put it in writing. Books are good, right? You say you're an author, you know what I'm saying, right? Everybody author, really, pretty much. If you have a testimony, you're an author, You can write a whole book about your life. It's going to sell, The real life sale.
Facts.
Real life sale. I can't sell Poo Poo and Ray Ray ran and you ain't ran nowhere doing nothing. So, just be real about what you want to do in life and it will sell. So, look, we're going to take a small commercial break. We're going to come back with my guy. He's going to perform live on the Monee Phillips Show. We'll be right back, DJ.
Yes, we're about to pay some bills, so we'll go on and take a commercial break. So don't stay gone too long. Come back, and you won't want to miss this.
Panda. 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 Panda.
It's your boy Mikey Christian on the Monee Phillips Show. So make sure you tune in. Bring a friend, tell a friend. We are about to go in.
Wow, wow. Turn me up a little bit. Wow, wow. Yeah. I can make it bounce like this. Pull up in the whip, black 10. Talking real fly, Clark Kent. I can be fair, pop a man. Two girls, I think that they twins. They on my team cause I win. I'm only scoring with 10s. I done made bread on my pen. Come on. In the rim, just like Carter. Started a doubt of the kids, so I went harder. You know I'm just too focused, why don't you bother? She keep on calling me daddy, I don't have a daughter. Whoa, whoa, please watch out when I move. Think it's a game you gon' lose. They saying it must be the shoes. They watching me like the news. Never stressed, keeping it smooth. I'm known to giving the blues. Walk out there back and came out with them blues. Spent some time in Memphis. Spent some time in New Jersey. She my number one fan, so I had to sign the jersey. She had perfect features. Get so much love in Toronto, need a Drake feature. She want me, but don't know my name like Alicia. I can make you bounce like this. Pull up in the whip, black 10. Talking real fly, Clark Kent. I keep it fresh, pop a man. Two girls, I think that they twins. They on my team cause I win. I'm only scoring with 10s. I done made bread off my pen, come on. Arm in the rim, just like Carter. Started a doubt of the kids, so I went harder. You know I'm just too focused, why would you bother? She keep on calling me daddy, I don't have a daughter. Whoa, whoa, fourth quarter, you know that I'm clutch. I treat her up like it's lunch. Trip on them just like a slush. It's no love, bunny lust. I don't know where like a brush. She ride with me like a bush. Do it so good, make a blush. Do it so good, make a cuss. Sippin' on pineapple crush. I put the crowd on hush. I put your face on mush. Excuse me, I'm blowing it. Told her, let's take a walk. My ex used to cheer for the Hawks. Dumped on time on the clock. And I just play the game, I don't talk.
Make it bounce like Vince.
Like Vince. Pull up in the whip, black 10. Talking real fly, Clark Kent. I keep it fresh, pop a man. Two girls, I think that they twins. They on my team cause I win. I'm on the squad with 10s. I done make bread on my pen, come on. Arm in a brim, just like Carter. Started a doubt of the kids, so I went harder. You know I'm just too focused, why would you bother? She keep on calling me daddy, I don't have a daughter, whoa. Like Vince, yeah. Like Vince, yeah. Wow, like Vince, wow. And I'm pulling up in dark tea, yeah. Wow, let's go.
Y'all, we are back on the Monee Phillips Show. Didn't y'all just join that performance? Man, doing his thing, man, all the time, man. I tell y'all, this is what you need to do, man. Performance is always intact. Make sure you do this all the time so they'll help you out. Even if you have to go in the bathroom and rap it out, you know, in the mirror, so you can see your moves, how you do things. So tell everybody how they can get into your projects and everything on social media.
All right. On Facebook, it's Mikey Christian. M-I-K-E-Y Christian, you know. And you can find me on Instagram, same thing, Mikey Christian 901. Five Hit Combo is on Apple Music, Spotify. Anything music is at, I'm at. So tap in, Mikey Christian.
Yeah. You got any projects you all got coming up?
We working on my producer. Matter of fact, shout out to Skinnermane. That's my producer, okay. Engineer. We did Five Hit Combo together. Now we got 10-piece combo finna drop. So
Okay.
It's going to be a project/short film, so just be looking out for all that.
Okay. right. So, man, look, he's doing some work, putting it out here. I am so glad you came on the Monee Phillips
Show.
Thank you
for having me.
Man, this is a fantastic, man, event to, you know, to get your project out. That's where you need to come, the Monee Phillips Show. We do this every Friday night, 8 p.m. You do not want to miss an opportunity. If you have not had a chance, this is like no other. I treat you just like you are kings and queens when you come in here, because that's what y'all are when y'all come on the show. I just want y'all to feel like y'all have done all the hard work and dedication to get where you at now. So when you come on the show, this is to promote you and push every revenue of all the stuff you have put into it. Because a lot of people don't know what you have did and done. They just see the outskirts of things. They don't really know your testimony or who you are. They just seeing it by people sharing. You know, people can share you but not know you. You know what I'm saying? That makes sense. Yeah, like I tell everybody, I promise I don't know 13,000 y'all on social media. I promise I don't. But y'all, I swear I know everybody. They be like, you poo-poo right away, friends. No, I don't know if they are. Thank you for your support. But I promise y'all, I don't know everybody, y'all. I do try to recognize certain ones. I know my fans. I know the ones that are always saying something on my posts or whatever. I know people when they see me out in public, I may not know your name, so forgive me. It's just how I am, y'all. It's not no harm. But a lot of times, I don't know everybody that watches my show. I don't know everybody that's out there, because you got to look at it. We are Fire TV, Roku, Apple TV, all over the world. So I have people from Africa, everywhere watching me, and they contact me on all social media saying something about what time they watch the show. Then, of course, you know, we still on Comcast 17, so we still doing it. And you got a lot of people that watch the website and everything that contact to try to get on the show. So I promise you, y'all, I love all of y'all. Y'all can continue to keep supporting SVP Network, the Monee Phillips Show. We're doing great things over here. Make sure y'all book your spots. I got openings in April, May coming up as well. So make sure y'all book and get on the show. I couldn't tell you no other way. Now, of course, y'all already know I explained to y'all that I am the wardrobe stylist for Rip Entertainment Film. So if you have your own clothing line, I'm looking for you. Men clothing, really. So we can get your paraphernalia out there in the movies. Man, this will be a great exposure for you. So if you're interested, hit my inbox, and I'll be glad to talk with you more about it. Make sure y'all, you know, continue support of what we are doing. We are doing a lot of interviews with these concerts. We got concerts back-to-back in Memphis. So no telling where the Monee Phillips Show and the team may be. This weekend, I will be, we had Angel Burrows on the show talking about the Tiffany Brunch, second annual Tiffany Brunch. I am one of the panelists and the honorees at this brunch tomorrow from 11 to 2. Man, y'all see more of it on my page, so make sure if you haven't got a ticket, I think she have a few tickets left, you come back tomorrow and get a chance to hear me speak tomorrow at the event. Also, I'll be doing the rocking chair tomorrow night. We are at the rocking chair at 8 o'clock p.m. The Monee Phillips Show and the team will be in the building to interview Sheba Potts Wright. Memphis on. We'll be there interviewing her. So, man, we got a lot of things coming for us. So, y'all make sure y'all support us and keep watching and see what's up next. But most definitely get your spot on the Monee Phillips Show. We do the show every Friday night, 8 p.m. Download the app, SVP Network. Catch us, the Monee Phillips Show, on Facebook, Instagram, and make sure y'all check out the wonderful website made by Natasha Norman. Make sure y'all check it out, man. We got so many different things they have seen. I want to spend a special shout out to my PR, Miss Marion, for making things happen for the team, for interviewing Jeffrey Osborne, the Manhattans, and Chick Rogers. So we had a fantastic night last weekend, man. We had a ball at the Cannon Center and many more to come. Yeah, my team was there, Chris Jefferson and Darren Carton. So we was there, man. We had a ball, so more to come, y'all. So, man, y'all check us out, and we will see y'all for another dope show next Friday. So stay tuned. Bye, y'all. And shout out to my DJ, DJ King.
We the best music.
Another one.